All right, hello, it's Sarah, and we are back for part three, I believe. I don't know. I'm filming this. Ugh. I'm going to be doing some shading today. So I am choosing to shade with paint, but you can use your favorite method. I would suggest the Faber-Castell Pitt pens, the big brushes. They work fantastic. I don't really want to do it on here. I guess I could wipe it off, but I don't need to. But for this, we're going to float. And because it's a mixed media piece, you don't have to be perfect, which is kind of great. I'm going to use candy bar brown. And just because it's kind of like, you could use burnt umber, raw sienna, any brownish color for the sun. Like, I'm going to be using candy bar on the pink stuff, on the cat, probably like all the yellow and brown stuff. I'm going to be using candy bar just because I don't know why. I just like it. So I'm putting a little bit on my palette paper. Got a clean bucket of water over here and I'm wetting my brush, and I like to use an angle brush. They're really getting beat up. This has actually got crud on it. So let's see how it goes. It's getting a little beat up. Blot on a paper towel. Corner load. Just put the corner of the brush in the paint and then blend it into the bristles. And take that and go with the paint edge up against where you want the darkest color. So I'm going to do each one of these rays of sun up against the sun going down the ray. So that was a lot. I'm going to grab my mop brush and just pull the color down a little. Mop it down at the water's edge. But see, I am really fast at this technique. You guys might prefer to just use your Pitt pen, and when you do, you just mark it where you want the color and then smudge it with your finger, and you'll get the same result basically that I'm getting with the paint. I just really like floating, so that's why I'm doing it. This is what I'm deciding now is my style, and no one else really does it this way. I mean, decorative painters probably do, and I think that mixed media artists do use paint, don't get me wrong, but they don't necessarily use this technique, which is fine. So that kind of gives it, you know. Oh, I missed one. Missed one of those little suckers right here. So now it looks separated from, and I could kind of do the edges too, but I'm not gonna. I'm going to leave them bright. I'm going to do the back. I'm going to consider this that facing forward. So get a little more water, blot on my paper towel, reload the brush, and I'm going to do the back of the sun's face, like from here to here. And the way I do it is I slide my brush. All the bristles, it's an angle, but this whole edge goes onto the surface, and so that the water is there as well. Water. I say that because I live in New Jersey. I like New Jersey. All right, so that's that. I'm gonna let that dry, and I'm gonna get some Payne's Gray, which is kind of like a dark blue, really dark blue. Gonna do the same thing, but on the blue this time, just gonna add, I'm gonna stick with this big brush. I like this big brush, and I'll show you. So I can kinda, I think I'm gonna go down, let's see, let me pick a side. I'm gonna go down the left side of the blue triangle. So what I mean by that is stick my color in the corner and pull it down along the side of the left of the blue. Does that make sense? So I'm on And I just always have a Q-tip at the ready. If I don't like it, I can take it off. So see what I mean, how that's, if this is a little, I can't, yeah, you'll see what I'm saying. And there's no real reason for me doing it on the left side, because we don't really have a light source since the sun is the light source. I am just choosing to add a little shading. I could actually do both sides if it was, if it was a realistic painting, I probably would be doing both sides. But it ain't. It isn't. It's just pretend, isn't it? It's whimsy, isn't it? I'm speaking English. I've been doing a lot of accents lately when I'm videoing. It's kind of weird. But I get silly when I'm excited and when I'm having fun. So, you know, that's what you get when you come paint with me, because I'm happy. So I'm just doing this, and I have plenty of paint on my palette. Stick the corner in that, go down the side, go back, and I will be done this in a jiffy. And then we're going to do the face. Put a face on it. Put a face on them. Almost there. Oops. Hopefully I'm in the shot. My hubby moved the camera up, and I could move it down so you can see better, but I'm kind of liking the, I think this one's been used. It's a little crusty. Love it. I have one more spot to go. And it just adds a little bit of depth and dimension. And I could actually highlight, that was my phone, highlight all the stuff too, you know, highlight on the other side, but nah. What? Oh God, I'm being very sloppy. Okay. Ta-da. All right, so. Let me take a look. I like it. Some are darker than the others, but I don't mind. So let's put his face on, shall we? I'm going to have his face turned kind of, I think, actually facing more forward. And I have this, I like these. These are General's Layout. I don't know. I found these at Hobby Lobby because I was looking for something that, a pencil that is very black, and this said extra black, and now I can't think of the name of it, but it's the one that a Stabilo pencil. Anyway, that's what Kate Crane recommended when she was doing sketching, but I just bought this extra black and I really like it. It came in a two set, so I'm going to sketch out a little face. Oh, I'm speaking English again, am I? My mom was English. And my aunt, both of them from England. Stop, Sarah. All right, so eyes kind of don't go at the top. They go more in the middle. So I'm just going to start by getting kind of putting an eyebrow kind of in the middle and pull it down to a nose and put a little nostril. And there you go. So now we have, and they're not exactly perfect, but see, this comes off. And then you get your little lip thing and that. And we're going to make a smile. I'm down a little far, I think. Oh, my hubby's not feeling good. But all this can be changed. This is just your guideline so that you can, and he has a little, so I'm gonna put it on with, you know what, I'll zoom in. I know you can't see any of that. There we are. He has a little face. It's a little crooked. And then I put little wrinkles on his forehead. But you can make his eyes thin and narrow or open. And I just try to do my best and get them even. because, you know, it looks weird when your eyes are uneven. How's that looking? Pretty even? Good. It's a little low because now I don't have room for a chin. I'm going to move it up. I'll be right back. Okay, I just erased it and moved it up a little bit, but I'm going to show you a really easy way for you to not panic and think, I can't draw that right on there, okay? But I did. I moved it up a little bit so I could just fit a chin. I like it better that way. All right, but look, I'm going to grab, oh God, now I can't find it. It's here, don't worry. I should have gotten it before I turned the thing back on. Well, you know what we're going to do? Pretend this is tracing paper. I don't know where mine is. It should be right here. So tracing paper. Get yourself some tracing paper. Or even, see, I'm just skipping a step. Draw your face. You know, get a little circle. So you know how big you're going with. And sketch your face onto a piece of paper or onto tracing paper. And then you don't have to worry about going, you know, not doing it right. And you can just, but this is basically what you do. Don't do that, but make your nose cute. And you can make big eyes or little eyes or any kind of eyes you want. I also put a circle, and I got that from Diane Salter. And you just kind of make it a real, I like to call it a Inca, like the Incans or something, like it's tribal, right? And I put wrinkles on his forehead, and I usually put a little, he looks really tribal. I don't know if you can see that. But then when you like your face, when you like it, then bring it over and put it on top of your piece and use tracing paper, graphite. Put the graphite underneath and trace your face on, and then you have your face on here so you like it, okay? I don't want anybody to freak out, and or you know what? Leave it without a face, but I love the faces. So for me, this is going to be good. I'm going to get some white paint, and I also have my Posca paint pens. Oh, I want to use my big, where it is? This one. I just found these when I was jelly printing. I went down the basement to look for paint, and I have this Jansen Art Traditions white paint that was $5 a tube, and I'm using it. I forgot about it and had it a long time, actually, but it is still fine. And I'm so glad I'm using it. So I'm just using, this is like a number two round. I'm going to treat myself to some new brushes. Next paycheck, I'm going to probably order them. And when I do, I'll share with you what I got. But you can't get good brushes at the, maybe Hobby Lobby. You know what, I could check Hobby Lobby because I don't go there as often. But Michaels and AC Moore do not have the good brushes that I like. They sell a lot of packs of brushes, and they're not what I'm used to. So I am filling in the eye area with white first. That's the very first thing I'm going to do. I want to do a couple coats just to get it opaque, which it doesn't even really need to be. It could be chippy choppy looking or painterly looking if you just, you know. Let's do the lips. See, I like this pink. This pen, my big brush in the pink, I don't know why, but I really like this color on the cheeks. It's called Middle Purple Pink. And I'm just going to do a circle and a circle. Try and keep them the same size. That's tricky. Can be tricky. Circles grow on me all the time. And I'm not going to do pink lips this time. I want to do like the candy bar lips. I'm going to do, that is so crooked. That one's up and that one's down. So let's see if I can get it off because this is India ink. We have the matte medium. Yep, it comes right off. Before it dries, you can get it right off. But I always have a Q-tip at the ready. But the matte medium makes it very easy. So I just have to hold this and really, I'm going to look at it. I have to tip it up a little bit to look at it so I can see what I'm doing. And you know what? The cheek police are not going to come around and say your cheeks are uneven. Good enough. That's what you have to say. Good enough. But I think I want to try and do like this candy bar. Maybe I'll mix it with a little bit of white and come up with a lip color. And they're going to be really dark. So I am painting in that pencil line just to get the shape. I don't love that color. I just went straight back into the candy bar. And just get some lip color on there. I like to put that little point. Boy, there's some voluptuous lips. This sun has voluptuous lips. What else? Let's just put another coat of white on there while it's... See, I do thin coats instead of one thick one. And if you do 2 to 3 thin coats, you'll be done. And it covers. And it's nice and smooth. So, that's what I'm doing. I have a little bit of red in my brush. I can kind of see. Cute. So it's already starting to come to life. We're going to, you know what, let's move on to another, let that dry and we'll move over to, let's do the B step. Yay. Okay. Because I have all the colors we need to shade this stuff out, we're going to do some shading. And if you need to, you can make lines on your B step, little guidelines that are going to take you from here to here, and they can kind of curve because the B-skep is a round thing. It's not straight. It's not flat is what I'm trying to say. So it's going to kind of go swoop. So I'm just getting a line here that'll guide me. And you probably can't see that, but once I start shading, you'll be able to see it. And I put my bees on. I don't know if you saw me with my finished bees. When I stamped out my bees, I stamped on the back of the paper to get them to face the other way. So all you need to do for your little bees is, I love this. This is the Uniball Vision Fine Waterproof Ballpoint Pen. And it works great. So for this little bee guy, he has, I'm going to zoom in so you can really see what I'm doing. Hopefully it'll stay focused. Wow, we're really in there. I'm copying off of this bee and just doing the opposite. So the back wing comes forward. And this one goes there. Then he has like a stripe here and a little tail, and it's like that, right? And you could do it solid. He has a little smile and a little eye. So he looks like a bee. And when we, I'm gonna add stickles and stuff. Gonna do that to all the other bees that are facing the wrong way. Well, they're not facing the wrong way, they're facing the other way. Put a little smile and a little closed eye. Give him a stinger. Don't forget the stingers, because I cut his stinger off. And right here, but see how this pen is like really great? You can use a Sharpie, my Posca paint pens are just a little too thick for these little bees, so I'm gonna let that dry. Give them stingers. What else? All right, let's shade the bee scat. I'm gonna use my smaller angle brush, water, blot, and that candy bar brown, and do some shading. I think I'm gonna go on both sides of the line, and this is because I've painted a bee scat or two in my past. But let's go under it first. Okay. Just go all the way down the same way. And just push it up against the bee and continue. Oh, it's smudging. The ink is smudged. You have to let it dry. So that's my bad. I should have let that dry. Oops, went up too high. It'll be fine because we're going to put a line there with the pen after. So don't be too worried about. When I did the other one, I used the big brush, Faber-Castell big brush, and I just put a line down the middle and smudged it towards both sides, and it looked fine. So I'm having fun though, you guys. I love to do this. I'm gonna go around the hole. And I just cut that hole with a circle punch, add a brown cardstock, and put that on there. Because I wanted it to be dark inside the hole because it's kind of like the entrance. And just how I pictured it. Dark. Q-tip again. Just like to have my Q-tips. Gonna do up by the handle and shade, let's see. Here and here and here. All right. And I could shade each of the bees along the bottom, but I'm going to leave there. They need to dry. So I'm going to take this color and do a little bit on the flowers. And if you were using your big brushes, just put a little smudge of something. And this is just all personal preference. I'm going to paint the centers too, like green probably, or, and you do not need to do this. It's just a little extra. So that's what you would do for, just to make your flowers seem like they're dimensional. I feel like I'm scratching the bottom of the tissue box. I don't want to. I'll put this by. Okay. So that's the flowers. And I'm going to show you the grass. So I need black green for that. I don't know if I mentioned it when we were doing the other parts, but I did put a piece of green paper on the bottom, kind of cut like a little hill or a patch of grass, and then put my bee scat on top of that. But I don't know if I mentioned that. I must have. All right, so this is black green, and let's see, I want to do it along the bottom. Don't even know if I'm in the shot. And I wasn't. I'm gonna zoom up. That's why I don't like zooming, because I always forget I'm zoomed and I get out of the shot too much. And I got it on the box, which it might come off because there's gel medium there, but nah, not so much. And then I'm gonna just take that black green and kind of go around the flowers on the grass. Just like kind of make them look like they're casting a shadow or something. And then right up against the B-Skep, under it. Ooh, way too much water. Like, and we have all this other stuff, but I'm gonna stick this, hopefully I'm in the shot. Under this little snail and around. So it just kind of gives it a little more what? Dimension. And then you could do it on all the leaves. You just take, oh man, I stuck my finger in the pile of paint, sorry. I like to do it on the little heart part of the leaf because that's the base. And you could highlight the tips, but I'm just gonna leave it. But now you can actually kind of see them more than you could, I think. And we can go back to the sun's face in a sec. What was I doing? Oh, this. So if you're, again, just use a dark pit pen. And you could just use your brown for all of this. Because that's what a lot of mixed media artists do. They just use that brown to give it like an antique-y look. Now I just put black green on that. Duh. I don't want black green on that. I want the red. Alright. So let's see. We're going to do the other side of this line. Let's see. You guys probably don't have to if you've been using the pit pen. Just as long as that you see a separation between the sections of the beehive. That's what I call a B-Skep sometimes. I guess a B-Skep is a hive. I'm not sure. And I should be starting at the bottom because I don't want to put my brush over areas that are still wet because I'll pick it up. Hopefully that worked. I like it. We still have to shade down the sides. And so we're going to come back to that in a minute. Let's go back to our... Alright, we have... I think we could do some shading. And then we'll brighten up the eyes. So let's do our shading on the face with that same color. I need some more Candy Bar Brown. And... I'm using my small angle brush. I'm going to put the color underneath his little eyebrow here and swoop it down this nose, the bridge of his nose, kind of around his nostril and leave it there. And do the same thing to the other side. paint edge up against the eyebrow area and go down all the way down the bridge of the nose and around that nostril. Kind of tuck it in. But see how I totally washed out the eyes, so we'll come back and brighten that up. I like to do a little on the forehead, like that makes it look like he's got a little wrinkly brow. So I'll just leave that there. Put a little for a chin. And I think that's it. That's all we really need for, you could get so more detailed, but for what we need, we're good. I'll put one more wrinkle on his brow above this one. A little shorter. How's that look? Good enough? I don't like that it's like... we gotta brighten up the eye though. I just totally took away that bright white. And then we'll do his eyelid and his eyeball. And what else does he need? That's all I do. I don't do any other real details. I think Diane had put like flowers in his cheeks, and I mean, you could doodle all around. You could doodle his little sun rays and all that stuff if you want to. Just make it your own and do what you want. Like, we could actually be highlighting his lip with a little bit of white, like just a dry brush. And then when I outline it, it'll be cool. Like, yeah, dry brushing on this, oh my gosh, that would look so good. All right, so we're gonna let that sit. Go back over here. I'm gonna take my bigger brush and do down both sides of the B-skep, because it's round, so the highlighted area would be in the middle. So I'm gonna go down both sides and do that. I'm gonna have to figure out how I'm gonna brighten it up in the middle. I think with yellow paint or yellow paint pen. I think that's gonna do the trick for me. Let's do a little shading on the snail. I'm gonna brighten his little antennas back up, and we'll put some. These are my fine point Posca paint pens, 0.7. And I'm going to use the green to do the centers of the flowers. And basically just color them in, just kind of scribble them in. I like this color green though. It's a very bright, vibrant green. And we can shade this too, or just put stickles on it. I might just put stickles on it. I didn't shade this one yet, so. But look how pretty that green is. It's so pretty. I think I'm gonna give my son green eyes. I've given him blue eyes a lot. Oh wait, we have to do the cat too. We'll do the sun blue and the cat green. So is that starting to come together? You know what we have to do. The Payne's gray. So I'm gonna go around the B-skep now on the outside with that dark blue, and I'll show you what that does to make it pop. So I'm loading my brush. I'm doing the same technique all through this whole piece to paint, to get the shading on there. So I set my brush down up against where I want the darkest color, which would be up against the B-skep, and put pull the color up, but I have water on my brush too, so it fades into the background. And I'm picking up more color. I'm gonna put it on inside there. And you guys would just be doing the same thing, but with your big brush or any other way that you know how to get a shading technique or shading situation going. So now it looks like he's kind of set into the background instead of on it. And I'm just going to do the same thing with kind of like along the top of the grass line here, around this flower, all the way over to here. You could even do it a little bit under each bee to make them seem like they're, I don't know if it looks right or not, but let's see. I don't hate it. Around this flower. And I would definitely be holding this differently if I wasn't on camera right now. Like, it would probably be down in my lap. And it makes a difference. Like, get comfortable, make sure you can see well enough, and you'll have better results. That's good. I think I'll just do a little in this corner, just to frame out the, just a little bit here and here. That's it, just a little. What else? I got a shade on my little, he's done. He's gonna be done. I'm just gonna use that brown iron oxide, or no, candy bar brown, sorry, on his shell. Just, oops, right here. And that's good. My poor hubby. He's home. Coughing. I'm glad I'm staying away from him, because I don't want to get sick. All right, so I want to brighten up the bee skep, so we're going to have to figure something out. I think I'm going to use this yellow for right now and see if I can just put some lines in here. Now I'm just going to need brown lines or white lines. I don't know if yellow was the right color. I probably should have used like white. But I don't have a brown Posca paint pen, so I'm grabbing a thin liner and just making some, I'll make some thin lines with that. So this is all details that if you want to do it, do it. But see, I love the details. I always couldn't wait to get to the part where we were putting the details on, because the piece just comes to life when you add them. Put a couple on the middle too, because they're kind of fading into the background because they're the same color as the shading. So, but I like that. Looks good. It added highlight. It seems brighter in the center. Let's put a little yellow on our bees. Make them a little brighter. I want to brighten them up. Give them a little cheek of yellow and a little... I like that. And their wings are actually white, right? They're like clear. What should I put? Should I put a little, I think I am just gonna put a little white since I have some white out. And then I think I'll use like Winkastella or something at the end to give them just a little shine. But let's whiten them up like that. I don't think I did that on my other one. Oh, I like that pop of brightness. And I'm not doing it opaque. It doesn't have to be opaque. It just has to be sheer, whatever. I don't have words today, you guys. I'm like babbling. That's what happens sometimes. Oh, I like that. It brightened them up. Brightened up the bees. We can shade the centers of... First, let me just do... I forgot one little flower up here. But the centers of these flowers could get shaded. Am I just getting crazy with all that? I think it adds dimension. So let's see, that would be black green, right? Let's see. I think it's looking good. So let's go back to our sun, and I think we're ready for, well, that looks weird. Why is it? We're ready to add our color for the eyes. I like to do the eyeball first and then put my lid on. So what color did we say? Blue for these eyes, and I'm going to use the light blue Posca paint pen and just kind of... His face is a little crooked, but I put two lines like this and try to make sure they're even. I always do that side first because I'm right-handed. And that looks pretty good. And then just fill that in. Gotta let it dry. We're going to put a lid over that. What else? I guess we could start outlining while we're waiting for that. Because I definitely want to outline it. Oopsie. I follow the paper, but sometimes You go, like, you have to control your pen too. You can't just trust your the paper to guide you. You could do all this with a paintbrush or another pen, but I used to do all this with a paintbrush, a liner brush, and you would just make every little line with a paintbrush. It's so easy to just use this Posca paint pen. I really am. Oh, I am such a fan. Mixed media is, oops, so fun. Like, I'm so happy. And I know, I think the industry, like the decorative painting industry, probably took a hit because people aren't just doing that. They're doing it all now, you know, and scrapbooking has turned into all types of things. And so it's not just one thing anymore. It's kind of everything. And I love it. I'm going to turn this toward me so I can do this circle, because circles are just can be problematic. And so when I came on YouTube, I had been painting, and I've told this story before, but I had been painting for, you know, 15 years or so, and I was burned out pretty much. I wanted to try something new, and boy, YouTube just opened up a world of everything and classes on, because I used to go to convention and, I mean, seminars and pay to stay in hotels and take classes. So the internet is just so fantastic. So I'm so happy. All right. So I think those eyes are close to dry, but you know what we'll do? We'll just do the facial features. So I'm going to have to go off camera and do it because I want to make sure I do a good job. Let me look at the B-Skep. We can do some B-Skep stuff. So here's what you're going to do to finish this off and really give it definition, is to use your paint pen and outline all the details. So like on this flower, and you're going to connect your leaves. There's a little one right there. So look how much it pops all of a sudden, right? Let's do the B-Skep. And this can be as sketchy as you want it to be. It doesn't have to. I tend to, I think it's because of my decorative painting background, everything is pretty even and, you know, not sketchy looking. But I'm trying to add my own, because it is my work now. This isn't someone else's design. It can be. I want to go around this and go under here on top of that. So yeah, you guys don't need to see me do each thing, but just make sure that you add all the detail that you want. Get like I could put little grass lines and stuff. There's actually not a lot of ground. I'm just going to leave it. Oh, there's another leaf there. So I'm going to go away and do that. I'm going to do my face off camera. You know what? First, we're going to do this. First, we're going to do our eye. I like to make, see, it's a little bit wet still, the blue, but make just a U, an upside down U, and that's your pupil. So much easier with a pen than a paintbrush. Then we're going to outline and I hope I'm good because I'm at a really weird angle. Good enough, it looks even. And then I'm going to go gotta turn it so I can see it. Definitely points down over there. Just a little nostril and a little nostril. Don't get crazy. And then there's a little bump there. I'm upside down doing it now, huh? And we have to put an eyelid, and I just like to go. So we cut off a lot of the blue on that one. Shoot. I don't want it to be that low. So I'm going to make a mess. I can fix it. And then I'm going to use the paint. I'm going to take, I think this color. Oops. And do the eyelid. I just didn't want it that thick. I'll fix it. Oh, and then you definitely need, I forgot about the lines down the side of the eye like this. And then we'll put a highlight in there too. His lips are wonky. I could fix that with paint. I think I'm going to outline the cheeks too. I'm going to put a little more blue. Put more black there to fix it. But I think the pupil needs to be a little smaller. A little bit. And I got to fix the lip. Cute, right? So don't forget you can erase your pencil lines if before, and I'm going to put a coat of what's it called, matte medium, over this when I'm done, because I don't want to anything to come off. That's like the seal that I'm going to use, is the matte medium. Just want to make it have a little more Alright, and the black. Looks even enough, right? I think I... We could shade the top of the eye too by putting like a smudge of that black or the Payne's gray up there. But at this point, I keep touching and touching it. I really want to, but I don't think it's necessary. Let me try and do it like with a dry brushy. Alright, let's put our white dot on and then we're going to let it dry. I'm going to put it over here. Oh, I guess you should shake it down first and make sure you have paint. Because that wasn't even really paint. That was just like the stuff that's in the paint. That's paint. And you can put a little dot on his cheeks. And I think he looks good. So I'm going to leave him and let him dry. And we'll come back over here. And let's see what else. We didn't go around. I still have to go around a lot of stuff on here. I'll go off camera and completely finish both these sides. And then I'm going to... put a little coat of gel medium over it. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, everything's dry and done the way I want it to be. I actually added a little bit of iridescent pink on the flowers, green on the leaves, a little bit of white pearl, I should say, on the wings, and pink on the shell of the snail. So I'm going to do a little bit on the sun with gold. I've just got my gold. This is Dazzling Metallics by DecoArt, Splendid Gold. I'm going to just do a little bit to give it some shimmer, because you know I love shimmer. I'm just going to go around the bottom edge of this face. And I went off the lines a little. Over here, just, I think I'm going to put a little on some of these rays too, just kind of around these curves, maybe just on those long ones. Let's see, you know I can't resist having a little shimmer or bling. And I'm going to hit this with the heat tool, and then we're just going to coat it with one last coat of matte medium. Do I want to put a little, I'm going to put a little down the bridge of the nose and over the eyebrows a little. It's a sun. He can be blingy, right? Alright. Let me hit that with a heat tool. And I'm going to pop some... I thought I was all done with the matte medium today, but... So These colors to me look so tropical. Do I have my matte medium paint brushes around here? I'm just gonna pour it right on there and give it a nice even coating. And that'll just hold everything in place so it shouldn't come off. It's a barrier now. And then the very last thing I'm going to do when all the sides are done is add my stickles and probably a little, what is this stuff called? Glossy accents in the eyes and maybe on the lips. We'll see. So that's good. And then this side. And you know, I don't even know if like putting this on top of the metallic paints will dull them down or if you'll still see the metallic. We'll see. I hadn't really thought about that. And I didn't shade on the center. I could have shaded that with black. I still can after we do this. You can always add another layer on top of the matte medium. So there's that. I'm just going to use a napkin and take the majority of the gel medium out of the brush so I don't gunk up my water. Now we just let those dry. Alright, so I think that's it for now. I'm going to come back with the bird and the cat. We'll do these two sides on the next section. Alright, you guys? Thanks for watching.